What's happening in North Korea today, and why do analysts think that there may be a sixth nuclear test?
Well, there's been a lot of talk this week, Don, leading up to this holiday, the Day of the Sun. You were talking the birthday of North Korea's founding father, Kim Il-sung. And around these major holidays, North Korea has in the past chosen to display its military might through nuclear power. In fact, it was 5 years ago, just 2 days before this holiday, that North Korea attempted to launch a satellite into orbit. We have not, as far as I know, seen a nuclear test here in North Korea yet today. And I've been without my phone for more than 5 hours now, so you probably know what's happening up to date better than I do. We have to surrender our phones anytime we enter an event where North Korea's Supreme Leader Kim Jong-un is in attendance. But the military parade is just about to get underway, and I want you to take a look at this, because we often see the images of the tanks rolling by. This is something that we don't always see, the moments before the parade begins, when you have these North Korean soldiers, and if you zoom in on their faces, you can see these are very young faces. These are teenagers. They serve for 10 years in many cases, starting from age 17 or so up until their late 20s. They don't get married. They don't have a social life like you might think in the United States. Their lives are committed to defending this country in the event of a military confrontation. And just a few moments ago, these soldiers were chanting, you know, "We will die for you, our supreme leader, our supreme commander, Kim Jong-un." So this is obviously, this is a militarized country. They have a standing army of more than a million. And what we expect to see in the coming hours during this parade is perhaps a display of some of the new missiles and other weapons that North Korea has been developing. In the last year alone, they have perfected a submarine-launched ballistic missile so they could fire it from a submarine. They have a land-based ballistic missile that they can launch from a mobile launcher. These are solid fuel missiles. They fuel them up instead of with liquid fuel. It's almost like an explosive jelly, and it allows these missiles to sit in hiding and be rolled out and launched relatively quickly. So we could still see a missile launch today as some sort of a show of force. But the sense I'm getting from North Korean officials in regards to a nuclear test, if it was going to happen today, it is believed that it would have probably happened by now. Historically, North Korea has tended to conduct those tests in the morning hours, often around 9:30 in the morning. It's now just after 10:30 in the morning here. But Don, just because they haven't done this nuclear test today doesn't mean it's not going to happen. North Korea has it written into their constitution that they are a nuclear power. And analysts looking at satellite images from just a couple of days ago believe that the nuclear test site at Punggye-ri is primed and ready for a test really at any moment. So yeah. Could they do it when Vice President Pence visits the region in a few days? Could they choose another occasion? It's really not a matter of if, but probably when it comes to North Korea. And what we don't know, Don, is how the Trump administration is going to respond with that huge group of warships, the USS Carl Vinson Carrier Strike Group, now in the waters, in place, off the Korean Peninsula, equipped with a lot of missiles and a lot of, a lot of weapons that are an attempt to try to deter North Korea from doing this.
Let's talk a little bit more. And again, I can't stress how extraordinary it is that you're live there and what we're seeing behind you. And you said that we may have seen it if it was going to happen by now, but again, we don't know. Well, there's been an escalating war of words between Washington and Pyongyang. How much of this is real? Do we know? And how much of it is saber rattling?
Well, we're used to hearing from North Korea threats of nuclear annihilation of the United States. That's something that North Korea has said repeatedly over the years, if they're provoked, that they'll retaliate and there will be no survivors. And that's the kind of rhetoric that we're still hearing from North Korea now. But what's new in this dynamic here, Don, is President Trump. And the fact that President Trump is tweeting in real time his thoughts about North Korea, his thoughts about China and the United States trying to rein in the North Korean nuclear threat. And so we don't know how North Korea's leader Kim Jong-un is going to respond to these tweets that they might find very provocative. And then, of course, not to mention the fact that this huge conventional weapon, this MOAB, the mother of all bombs, launched on ISIS tunnels in Afghanistan, North Korea conducts its nuclear tests underground. And so you wonder, is this some sort of a veiled threat? And if so, how is North Korea and its leader going to respond to that?